For 21 years, Neighbours has been broadcast on the BBC, attracting more than 5 million viewers a day. The corporation, though, has withdrawn from the bidding to keep showing the programme because it would have cost about £300 million.
It was our first introduction to Kylie, Jason Donovan, and yes, that is Russell Crowe.
How should I know?
Because you're the one that put him out of business.
Scott and Charlene's wedding was a TV landmark, and it changed TV's landscape.
If you go back to, you know, 1986 when Neighbours started, you look at the cast of EastEnders then, they were the grimmest looking bunch of people you've ever seen. And then we had these pretty people, and it's sunny, and they've got swimming pools, and they're in and out in each other's houses, and everything's lovely, and everything's sorted out within four episodes. You know, it was a lovely, really sort of warm, sort of friendly thing that just drew you in.
And even though it's declined from its peak, more than 5 million people still watch every day. It's the second biggest show on BBC Daytime, and they've just lost it to Channel 5.
We were offered Neighbours for a price roughly three times what we've been paying. It would have amounted to nearly £300 million over an eight-year period, and we took the view that was too much.
The BBC admits it's a big loss, but it says it creates a new opening in the schedules, which could perhaps open the way for a more British alternative to Neighbours. But this is the end of a long, happy relationship. The problem, as it often is, money. David Sillitoe, BBC News.
Well, I asked Ben Nicholas, who plays Stingray in the show, if he was surprised at today's news.
I am. For years, I was on the show for three and a half, 4 years, and there was always rumours that it was going to be axed, or there's always things, always little things like that. And I guess when the new contract came up, it's a bit steep for BBC. But I think I don't know who's taken it, but I think it's starting in about March, April next year.
If well, the word is it's going to Channel 5, so it's going to stay on terrestrial television. But I mean,
yeah, which will mean that they've got Home and Away and Neighbours. I thought that would have been a bit.
Have an Australian hour.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is Neighbours still popular in Australia?
It's not as popular as it was in the day, which I was surprised because it still is quite popular here in Britain. I'm glad another station has taken it up because it's really been made for the English market now, because it's not as popular in Australia as it is. Do you
there
know what I mean?
There it is. Oh, familiar pictures.
There's Mum.
Yeah. Who's there?
That's place my mum, Janelle. There I am. Yellow t-shirt. I had a good time on the show. It's really good.
How long were you in it for?
Three and a half years.
Some of you will say the production standards aren't great. Is that just jealousy from this end, from the general?
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. Just what people say. The critics say. We had a critic on earlier today. He talked very pompously about production standards. He didn't compare it with EastEnders, but I suppose he might have done.
No. I mean, you know, obviously. I can't say that. No, it was not. I mean, the production values, you know, it's been going for 21 years, and I guess they've got a good formula which works. Why change it?
What's the secret of it?
Secret? I don't know. I think it's the sun, you know, EastEnders. And Neighbours is a bit funnier, a bit more humour, I guess. I don't know. Things like, people just say that it's because it's mainly watched by university students.
Well,
that's the main demographic.
Anita was telling me earlier that she spent every afternoon at university watching it.
Well, when I was at university, it was like a really a big cult thing, and that was, you know, Charlene, that sort of era.
the wedding and stuff.
Yeah.
But it's really made for that demographic, the university students. So.
But there are, I mean, lots of elderly people watch it. My old mum watched it well into her 80s, poor soul.
Was she studying?
She knew she was. Sociology, I guess.
Oh, well.
But, so you think it's a good show, but do you feel in a sense a bit let down that the BBC has walked away from it?
I don't know. They were with the show for 21 years, you know, so it was, you know, it was good, and they were good for each other. They had, you know, we had cross promotion and stuff. BBC would come over to Neighbours a couple of times a year and do. Blue Peter came over a couple of times, or you know, a BBC news program would come over and do a stint. So it was good. Do you know what I mean? They had a good relationship, but. You know, it'd be sad to be losing.
Do you think the fans will move with it to,
I hope so.
To five?
I hope so. It's a good show.
I'm interested when you said a little earlier that it's actually made now for the British market. I mean, what do you actually mean by that? Is it made differently than it was just for the Australian?
Well, it's Home and Away, they outgun us in Australia, but we get, you know, 4 million more viewers than them in Australia, in England. So it's, you know, if it wasn't for a UK station taking it on, I don't think it'd be made.
As you're in it, I mean, when you walk down the street here, does everyone sort of recognising you? And
What's wrong with my hair?
Well, it's just...
It's a little long.
It's a little different.
I'm getting a cut tomorrow. I was just saying I'm getting a cut tomorrow, so I'll be right. It's nice. I always say that if no one watched the show, I would never have had a job, so I guess you take it part and, you know, hand in hand with the recognition.
So tell all the Stingray fans what you do. What are you doing now?
What am I doing now? I'm actually trying to get work on the West End. I'm a musical theatre boy by heart, so okay. I'm just auditioning, trying to get work. So please, if you're in there.
So you're knocking on doors, on stage doors around the West End?
I am.
And we've got a couple more weeks of you in Neighbours.
Yes,
here.
I go out with a bang, so.
Oh, do you?
Can you give us any hints what happens?
Come on, just maybe.
I don't know, maybe when we go off air.
Oh, it's gone. No, that's not fair
on
the viewer.
That's not fair. I told you I'd have to kill you. You know.
Okay, you tell us and we'll tell them afterwards.
All right.
You've gone.
Thanks, guys.
Stingray, Ben, thanks very much
for
joining us. Great stuff.
Ben Nicholas talking to us a little earlier.